Arsenal fell to a second defeat in two matches since the Premier League restarted when Neil Maupay's late strike handed Brighton and Hove Albion a 2-1 win at the Amex Stadium on Saturday. It was a game overshadowed by a horrific injury to the away side's goalkeeper, with Bernd Leno having to be stretchered off in the first half. ESPN Plus, stream ESPN FC TV daily and 30 for 30, soccer stories. What did you miss? The latest from Europe's top leagues. Despite their expanding injury list, Mikel Arteta's side took the lead, when Nicolas Pepe finally got the best of Brighton keeper Matthew Ryan midway through the second half. Brighton didn't take it lying down, hitting back 10 minutes later when Arsenal's botched defending from a corner kick allowed Lewis Dunk to poke home. The visitors pushed on for a late winner, but it was Brighton who stole the 3 points after Maupay's cool finish to a great attacking move completed a remarkable turnaround for the Seagulls. Arsenal's young players have often led by example under Mikel Arteta's management, and today was no exception. Bukayo Saka was once again superb, this time deployed on the left side of a midfield four. He deserved a goal, but the closest he came to one was a first-half strike that cannoned back off the crossbar. Additionally, Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang and Alexander Lacazette playing as a striking pair from the start provided a threat, with their link-up play leading to some good openings. Leno's first-half injury was a real gut punch for Arsenal, who also saw a number of key players sidelined after Wednesday's 3-0 defeat to Manchester City at the Etihad. Leno's knee appeared to twist upon landing, raising concerns over what could well turn out to be a long-term layoff. After his heroics against City, he's going to be sorely missed. Arsenal's late defensive collapse will also be of concern moving forwards. Manager rating out of 106, Arteta had few other defensive options this afternoon, with his first-choice centre-backs absent due to injury or suspension. However, the Spaniard did make the bold call of setting his side out in a makeshift 4-4-2 formation. It worked well going forward, with Saka and Pepe performing superbly from wide positions.